The Atwal affair continues to dominate question period. After last week's marathon voting tactics, opposition MPs continue to demand the same information from National Security Advisor Daniel Jean. Information they say he gave the media on the Prime Minister's India trip. Trudeau says Conservative leader Andrew Scheer was offered a briefing, but refused it. And around and around and around it goes. Who will give in? What happens if neither side concedes? Time for the power panel. In Calgary, former director of policy to Stephen Harper, Rachel Curran, and journalist Jen Gerson. Here with me in studios, Susan Smith of Blue Sky Strategies Group and Suma Strategies, Robin McLaughlin. Hi, everyone.
Hi, Bass.
Thanks
Hi,
very buddy. Much. Great Thank you for you. Joining me. Okay, Susan, I'm going to start with you. Why do they not just give up the National Security Advisor? Why does the government not just give up the National Security Advisor to a committee appearance instead of all this stuff about the briefing?
Well, there's a couple things going on. This is political grandstanding on the part of the Conservatives. And when you're a privy councillor, you are privy to, which Andrew Scheer is the leader of the opposition, you are privy to classified, you're able to be briefed on classified information or more secure information. So if Andrew Scheer really wants that kind of level of information, he should sit down and take that briefing. There's also a National Security Committee of MPs who all have also been sworn in as privy councillors. And I think what's important is to focus on, if they're looking for classified or higher level information, they have to use the processes that are in place there. Otherwise, it's just grandstanding on the part of the Conservatives.
Rachel, though, was the process in place, sending Daniel Jean to talk to reporters? It just seems a little bit confusing.
Well, Susan's point might be a good one if the National Security Advisor had not been sent out to brief the media on this. And so all of this material, the story that has been presented, is already out in the public domain. It has been presented to the media. So it's very unclear, actually, why the same information cannot be shared with elected officials. Why can it not be shared with parliamentarians if it's already been shared with the media, with the press gallery? So that's the really unclear question here. But what's more important, I think, is this unprecedented politicization of the public service that is happening under the Liberal government. So the guy at the middle of this is Daniel Jean, who's the National Security Advisor. He's also a public servant of long standing, excellent reputation, one of the best senior officials we have in Ottawa. And suddenly he's in the middle of this political, very political debate. He shouldn't be there. And he's been put there, it seems, by the Liberal government in an effort to cover its own tracks on this India trip, which was a complete debacle.
Let me get Susan to reply to that. Is that a fair characterization?
No. Actually, it's actually completely inaccurate, except for the fact that what a great public servant Daniel Jean is. Absolutely. I agree with Rachel on that.
Was he not kind of paraded around to the media?
No. The public service, when they do those kinds of briefings like that, it's up to the National Security Advisor and his or her team to make the decision to make those briefings. And that's what happened. In no way were they put up by anybody political to do that briefing. They stepped forward. It's true, actually, Rachel. It is true. And I know it's true.
Nonsense.
They were. No, it's
Utterly
true.
Nonsense. You're
actually,
saying
no, it's
Daniel
not true. So what happened? No,
how
Rachel.
About, Susan, just, Rachel. How about we'll just get Susan to finish her point and then Rachel jump back in.
There was misinformation being perpetuated through the media with regards to this India trip and what was going on with Mr. Atwal's presence. The Privy Council office decided that they would have a briefing with media to clarify the inaccuracies that were there. And that's exactly what they did.
And Rachel, I'll get you to reply to that, and then I'd like to bring the other two in.
Yeah, no, that's utter nonsense. I think what Susan is saying is Canadians are expected to believe that the Trudeau government was under fire for inviting a convicted terrorist to a reception in India with Indian government officials, and conveniently the public service happened to hold a briefing to explain some other theory, rather far-fetched theory, to be honest, about why this person was there.
No.
Look, that's not credible. It's not even remotely credible.
Well, is that
actually
Robin,
true?
Excuse me, sorry. One second, let's bring Robin into this. Is that credible?
No, Liberals opened this can of worms, and now they have to deal with it. And the problem is that if Daniel Jean was good enough for a background briefing with media to help correct whatever the government felt was misinformation publicly, then he's got to be good enough for Canada's duly elected Parliament. It's only fair. Parliament can't do its duty, democratic duty, and hold the government accountable if it doesn't have the same information that the government is providing to the media. So there's no way that the National Security Advisor is going to go brief media without somehow somebody in Central, the Prime Minister's office, approving that. So I think it's really just not credible, the idea that this was his own whim to go out and talk to the media. And if Daniel Jean, if obviously the Liberal government doesn't want him before the committee because then they're afraid the opposition will be able to use his testimony against the government to make the government look even worse than it already looks on the there could be somebody else they could put forward, perhaps the minister, perhaps another senior public servant if they're worried about the National Security Advisor. There's got to be a compromise here or this story is not going
to
go away.
Jen, do you think that it's fair to characterize the Liberals as being afraid to put him in front of committee?
Well, I don't see any other reason for this. I mean, look, the Liberals ran for government under this banner how they were going to be so much more transparent and so much more open than Stephen Harper. Okay, well then put him into the committee and have him testify on what he briefed the media about. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, it really is just that simple. I don't see any way around it. I think both sides here are grandstanding for their own purposes, but that's fine, that's politics. I mean, from my perspective, what bothers me about this whole debacle is the fact that you allegedly had Mr. Jean give this off-the-record, on-background briefing to media in which he made these quite crazy allegations about how, you know, this whole Atwal affair was really the response of rogue government Indian officials.
That's not true either.
A huge diplomatic official. This is my understanding of the situation. Hey, you know what would really clear this up? Have him testify.
That would
be really clear the air. It'd be great, because I can only go on secondhand information my colleagues in the media have said at this point. So this is all I've got to go on. But to me, when you abuse the trust of a sort of off-the-record or background information among media in order to basically spin a story like this, you can't really expect the protections that you're trying to claim here. It's just, it's absurd.
Susan, does Jen have a point there in that this could actually, I mean, this is very confusing. Could it all be cleared up if Mr. Jean just appeared before a committee?
The issue is, if he comes and does something that's public in a public forum like that, how far do people understand how far he can go in terms of answering questions? We're talking about classified
security. Well, can he go any further than he did?
Well, he could go without the media.
No, he could. No, that's right. But there is a Parliamentary Security Committee. Andrew Scheer is a sworn-in member of the Privy Council. He could have a full-on briefing if he wanted it, but the Conservatives are...
But this isn't about Andrew Scheer.
...playing politics. But that was what today it was in the QP, in the House today.
Of course they are. They're all playing politics. So, he wants it to be public, so, and I think that that's a legitimate request.
But I think we have to be cognizant of what can and can't be public. But the record is confused. It's muddled. It needs to get better corrected. Daniel Jean did brief reporters. Some reporters got it right, and some reporters got it wrong.
Well, I think arguably the record is still...
I mean, like, it's almost like having a parliamentary system with a committee system right in place to allow him to take advantage of the situation and set my colleagues straight. I think that there's a great opportunity for the Liberals to do that. Maybe they should consider it.
And Robin, you want to weigh in?
Oh, Jen Gerson's making a lot of sense, so I don't want to cut that.
She always does.
I agree. Well, almost always. Susan's making a point that there was some misinformation in the public and there was some confusion here. There's no way you can say there's not still that confusion. His background briefing to the media did not clear this up. As Jen has rightly pointed out, there is a forum where he could do that. Liberals can't have it both ways. Either there is a serious, significant issue here that Daniel Jean talked to the media about, that there is a foreign government or elements of a foreign government that's interfering in our domestic affairs. And that's quite concerning.
And why would you brief the media about that? Like, I mean, I love to get all this information. I love getting secrets like this. It's wonderful. But if you did have if in this situation of what Mr. Jean is allegedly accused of briefing the media about is totally true, and that rogue elements of the Indian government were in fact conspiring to do all of this, if that is the case, then why in the world would you give secrets like that out?
Just to clarify one thing. No, just Susan, last word.
It's actually just to clarify one thing that does keep getting perpetuated here. Monsieur Jean did not say rogue elements of the Indian government. He said political elements in India.
How do you know that? Are you there?
She's had a private briefing.
Okay.
You had a private briefing.
Sorry, guys. Have to wrap it up. Yeah, private briefing over. We've got...